How is the disease diagnosed? Now, we have a list of possible tests. We're going to look at these, and doctor, if you would please look at these. And I would imagine that you've got to pair them off in combined tests from time to time, knowing what you're looking for, yes?
Yes. I think the first test is really the history, listening to the patient's history with a physical examination, whereas we listen for murmurs and listen for sounds of the heart. That's really the first indication that someone has valvular heart disease if their heart makes a noise when it beats that we call a murmur. The next test would be the echocardiogram or ultrasound test, which is a non-invasive test where we can judge the degree of the murmur, how severe it is, and how severe the leaking or stenosis is from the echocardiogram. And that's a completely non-invasive test, usually done as an outpatient. And you can tell the patient what the severity of the murmur is and how severe the heart disease is at that point. CT scans are important for looking at the overall function of the heart, sometimes looking at coronary arteries or looking at the size of the aorta to see if that's what's causing the aorta to leak. EKG is always important to look at the heart rhythm.
What is an STS score?
STS score is a score based on how severely the patient is ill. It's a Society for Thoracic Surgery score. It looks at how risky it is for the patient to have surgery.
What does it include when you put it in
that score? It includes things like the age, and kidney function, and other factors in the patient, heart strength, to look at how the score is then used to judge their risk for surgery.
Grip strength, I would understand. Gait test, would that involve standard walking as the gait?
It looks at how frail the patient is to judge how risky it is to have surgery.
And how often do you then have to get down to a cardiac catheterization? That would seem to be a little bit more invasive and something you'd have to wait for.
The cardiac catheterization is usually the last test when you've decided the patient is either a candidate for an intervention and we need to figure out what's going on exactly so the intervention can be planned exactly. And that's the invasive test, which is done in the hospital.